Hello everyone, we're glad to see you and hope you're doing great. 2022 was a huge year for War Robots with the announcement of a new game set in its universe. The Frontiers team is hard at work and will have lots of exciting news to share with you soon. But today we will focus on the OG War Robots. We have some massive updates coming your way. Please welcome the War Robots devs.
Hello everyone, Boris here, the War Robots producer. You will see the task system updated soon. The new tasks support new goals like repairing damage or surviving until the end of the match. Tasks will be split by category to declutter your task list. If a task is a part of a chain, you can now check the entire chain and see the rewards for each quest. There's also another little touch. Just like operations, tasks can now get story texts. The drones have been long overdue for an overhaul. We paid close attention to the way drones are played, the issues they create, and what is fun about them. And we are working on streamlining and improving the experience. Firstly, we're getting rid of the drone selection screen. Many players didn't like having an extra click between them and the fight. Also, few took the advantage of the flexible choice of drones before a battle. Most players would use a single drone for a particular robot. This is why drones will now become part of a robot's loadout, along with its pilots and modules. Microchips will be gone. The new drones are upgradable, just like pilots. Each drone has its own set of abilities, and we want to highlight the signature effects that each drone already has. This will allow us to balance each drone better and make learning the drones way more intuitive. If you see an enemy with a particular drone, you can be sure that you know what it does. Your microchips will be converted into a new resource that you can spend to upgrade your drones. Both the task and drone overhauls will arrive with the Q1 updates. Q1 is also when we plan to release the full version of our PvE single-player mode. Many of you have had a chance to hunt some AI spiders on the test server, but that was just a bare-bones draft of the mode. We've tested the technical side and made sure that implementing the new mechanics would be possible. A lot has been done since the last test. So now is probably the time to unveil what our PvE will look like upon its full release. The Grey Swarm approaches. Every few weeks, we will be offering you a challenge. The rules and rewards will change each time, but one thing will be always the same. Hordes of spider bots coming at you in waves. The swarm has grown smarter. It now has spiders built for specific combat roles, and you'll never know what they will throw at you next. To last through the 5 increasingly difficult waves, you will need both piloting and hunger building skills. Planning your deployments will be just as important as being smart when you move around the map. We know that many of you have full lineups of robots waiting in your backup hangar decks for months, if not years. After all, you only need 5 to play against other players. The PvE mode will finally give you a reason to dust off those second line bots. The new spider bots are no joke, and one hangar will hardly be enough to defeat the swarm. You can complete each stage as many times as you want to get a higher rank and collect the rewards you haven't received yet. And there is nobody to mess things up for you. You're on your own, and only your skill matters. Be prepared. The full power of the Grey Swarm will return this spring. That was all from me for today. See you next year, and happy holidays. Now let's invite Ciro. He'll tell you more about the upcoming robots and pilots.
Long time no see, Commanders. Ciro here. Let's not waste any time and talk about the new robot. This one provides a different kind of support. While all other support robots follow their teammates to make sure they're okay, this absolute gigachat of a robot takes the team where it needs them instead. It creates two-way portals, like those on Abyss, for its friends anywhere it wants to. Get the team out of the sticky situation or smuggle a whole bunch of robots behind the enemy lines. The playmaking potential this ability unlocks is immense, and we can't wait to see the combos you discover with this robot. Just please, be civil. Don't teleport your teammates into lava. New robots are fun and all, but what about the old ones? While you can't just turn a tier 3 robot into tier 4, there is still so much fun to be had with the classics. That's why we continue experimenting with the pilots for older bots. In 2022, Marie Leclerc reintroduced Mander into the higher leagues. NASA is bringing back Raven. What's next? We keep receiving requests for one particular explosive walker, and we felt obliged to deliver. In update 8.7, Oliver Song will enter the battlefield. He's an evil-eye hunter who refuses his calling to chase his passion for science. He's a gentle soul with lots to prove. The twist? Oliver Song is a Hellburner pilot. Stay tuned for the news. Here is a piece of the next Titan. What piece? I don't have the slightest idea. I leave the rest to you, detectives. We also want to remind you that the work on the maps is going full steam ahead. Here are some progress peaks of the upcoming Yamantau comeback. That's it from me for today. Stay safe, have an amazing holiday, and see you soon.
That was a lot of news. Feel overwhelmed? We've got you. If you're looking to get back on track in War Robots, this might be the best time as we've prepared something for you to get you up to speed. First of all, don't forget to hire Nessa during the ongoing Operation E. She's a powerful pilot, making your Raven worth of the higher leagues. You can also get her for free while the event lasts. But that's just a warm-up. Last Christmas, we gave Fenrir away to everyone. If you log into game right now, you'll get a shell with a legendary paint job for absolutely free. And we won't stop here. Starting from today, you'll be getting daily gifts until Christmas. Finally, on December 24th, you'll also receive 3 weapons to complete your shell build, all for free. There's a link in the description, make sure you click it, download the game, and collect your rewards. We hope you'll have an amazing time in War Robots with the new tasks, new drones, new PvE mode, and the new equipment. Thank you so much for playing War Robots. Happy holidays, and see you next year!